Reflect just released a new tool that lets you chat with any web page you're on. It's a Google Chrome extension. You can find it in the Chrome store. I'll put a link in this video, but it's just called Reflect Webchat. And it adds a chat bar to any web page you're on. So I'm going to go ahead and add it to Chrome here. Click add the extension there. And now it's up here. I'm probably going to go through, since I'm doing this in the video, and this is what I recommend, find it to actually pin up there. Where is it? There it goes. Cool. So I'll pin that there because that's something I'm going to want to click on pretty regularly. And let me go to this YouTube page. I'm going to walk you through some examples of how to use it and I'll show you how to set it up for the first one. So let's say this is a YouTube video, a recipe that I want to get. So I'm going to click on this. And because this is my first time setting it up, I'm going to need to add my either OpenAI or Anthropic keys. And Alex, who made this, I think he like made it in a weekend, added some information here. Let me close out of this really quick. Just that you do need the OpenAI or Anthropic keys. The requests are made directly to those APIs, so they don't log anything. And the keys are secured and saved locally. Also, all the code's open source. So we've got a few other details on here. It's MIT licensed. I actually didn't know that. but anyway, let me kind of show you how that works. So I'll pull that back up. And I actually have both Anthropic and OpenAI API keys, but let me do OpenAI. That's probably the more common one. And it brings you to this API key page, which it hides the secret keys. So I do think I can show this from people. And then you just create a new key and give it a name and then click create secret key. I guess I can go ahead and do this and I'll just have to cut it out because I think it will show the key. So I'll just say new WebChat key and I'll click create. I had to shut that part or delete that part out because I can't show anyone my actual encryption key or not encryption key, API key that I'm using for OpenAI. Oh, and I forgot to mention, there's currently a dark mode issue. There is some text here. There should be a fix for this, hopefully, by the time the video is released. But it's actually one of the reasons I wanted to show this part. There's some hidden text there that is the same color in dark mode. So I'm just going to paste my key here. I'm going to double click to make sure it's in there. And I'll click save. And then I'm good to go with this chat interface. So let me run through a few examples. Okay, so now I'm going to go back to my recipe video here. And let's say I want to make this. Oh, my video is covering it. What is it? It's a demi-glaze. And you know, I'm going to put this on silent and I'm just going to pretend I'm actually doing that. It is already. And so if I'm watching this and I want to make the recipe and it's a YouTube video and I'm like, oh my gosh, that's an overwhelming amount of ingredients. I can just pull up the web chat and, I could get a whole, recipe for it, but I could also just ask the ingredients. So let me say, please, the dark mode, pull a ingredient list from this video. And then I'm going to select this. Okay, I can see it, how well I did. I should probably have waited to do this video till the fix was in, but I was kind of eager. Nice. Okay, cool. And there we have the recipe list. So I can just copy that. And you actually can't see this either, but there's a copy button here. So, you know, I can just click that, copy it, and put it directly into my notes. Cool. So that's the video one. And I should also mention, if you haven't seen it before, Reflect has a Chrome extension for Reflect Notes. So this is separate from Reflect Notes, but this Chrome extension, if I wanted to actually save this recipe in the video in my notes, I can click this and a little check mark shows up. And then in Reflect on my daily note, I won't go ahead and show this because I want to focus on this Chrome extension, but it will save the link and any information I need to my notes. So that's the video. Let me now go to a subreddit. I think this is a really fun one. So this is something that I run into a lot where I find a really useful Reddit post, but there's so many comments, it's kind of overwhelming to read through them all. And so then it's like, well, I don't want to just read the top one. It's like, maybe I want to, you know, read all the comments. So what CAD do people use for 3D printing design? So I'm going to pull up the chat and I'm going to say, can you please list all of the main solutions for this question? Well, it's kind of a weird way to word it. I'm actually going to see how this does. And again, you can see I was in fact typing there. Sorry you couldn't see it. But This is going to be a good experiment because I actually, all of these are the first times I'm doing them on the links, because once you do a chat, then it leaves the chat open. So if I come back to this page later and pull up the chat again, it will keep the same responses. So the fact that there's no existing responses says I'm doing this for the first time on these examples. So let's see if it works. Cool. And then it will just summarize all the solutions in the responses. Maybe a better one for this would have been like someone trying to find, I don't know, I maybe should have done like a problem one where someone was trying to find, like maybe you're, I don't know, like having a problem with the new iPhone iOS software or something. And I could have listed all the solutions, but you get the idea. Okay. Maybe this one will be better for that. So this one, how to blow out your sprinklers before the winter. I'm going to use Super Whisper to type this since you can't see me typing anyway. So I will say, please list out these steps in order, very condensed into a simple checklist. See what that does. Cool. So now I just have the list here. And I don't have to read all the other nonsense for this SEO optimized article because I just want the steps here. You can also imagine, I showed the recipe example for YouTube, but you can see how that would also work extremely well for a written recipe where they have like novels of text describing their entire life backstory before they actually show you the recipe. So recipe example. And then the last one here, this is an article I actually wrote, but I don't know, thought I would just use it as an example. And this could be any article you're reading. I'm going to use the pre-built prompt here, pull out the main points from this page. And you can use this for any article and it will, again, pull out the key points. Something else I could do is I could say, I actually haven't tried this one very much. Please write me a short LinkedIn post based on the information in this article. By the way, that tool I'm using to transcribe, it's called Super Whisper, superwhisper.com. We're big fans of it. So go check them out. No affiliation. So that's a bit long. And so in the spirit of treating this like a chatbot, I'm going to say, that's great, but can you rewrite it without any emojis, any hashtags, and make it much more condensed? Okay, cool. So that's much shorter. And then I would probably just take that, copy it into LinkedIn, and I don't know, please faith it. But I could continue going on. I could ask it to format it better. I could ask it to rephrase it, all sorts of stuff. So there's a ton of different things that you can do for this. If you're in sales, it's really good at describing just what a company does really quickly. It's shocking how many companies are bad at describing what they actually do. So that can be really useful. Research would be really useful. I actually should have maybe done that as an example, but you know, you could pull up a PDF or a research paper, research article, and just ask it questions. Maybe you're learning like something complex like biochemistry, and you could just ask it questions about the page you're on. So a lot of applications, check it out. In the video, I will put a link to the Chrome store and give us a good review while you're there, because this is just something that was released for free under the Reflect brand. And yeah, Alex just made it for fun. It's super cool. This is honestly one of my favorite things he's made so far recently.